Once, when this was a single realm, long before the Sigmarites, before the Deepkin and endless spells as well, before Realm Gates, Nighthaunt, Grand Alliances, before Bone Reapers and Double Turns, in the time of the Old World.
Hey everybody, welcome to the very first episode of the Warhammer Fantasy Battle series that you guys helped support with the Kickstarter campaign. In the very first episode you're about to watch, it'll be Luka versus Cullen in a 2400 point game. Now, if you've been following all the Kickstarter videos, you saw the three of us playing a Triumphant Treachery game, meant to be the first game of the series, but unfortunately that footage was lost. It happens so very rarely, but it does happen every now and then. So instead of postponing the series even further down the line and give you a Triumph Treachery first, we decided to give you the regular stuff first, and we'll get to that stuff with the Triumph Treachery eventually. But we lost the footage, didn't want to delay any longer, so let's get right to the battle rep.
Hey there, Wargamers, and welcome to some of the promised Warhammer Fantasy Battle Reports that, well, you paid for. This is actually the first one that Cullen and I are recording together. There's going to be a whole series he's coming up with kind of random pair-ups, right? So in this case, it's going to be Cullen and myself, 2,400 points, Vampire Counts versus Skaven.
Oh, yeah. Just running back some, I think, similar to our usual lists, yes. I think. Just trying to get it back into the feel of it.
Right, this is very much our go-to stuff, right? I got the Graveguard Bomb, you got the
Storm
Pokeboard.
Vermin Horde.
The Storm Vermin Horde.
Vord.
But you know, bear with us here as we get our feet wet in Warhammer Fantasy Battles 8th Edition again. And I will be doing some 6th Edition Battle Reports in the future. Can't say when. I have to skim through that book again because it's sparse. The knowledge is sparse. It's been a long time since I played that.
2 years? 3 years?
It's been about two. I think it's been about 2 years since I played it. And, you know, I've played a lot more 8th edition since then, so you have to understand that. But I will get some 6th editions coming up for you in there.
Just let us get our bearings back into fantasy.
Right. And what we're going to do here is one of the random scenarios out of the book, but do you want to avoid the Watchtower or you don't care?
Okay, it's one of our first games. Let's re-roll sixes.
Yeah, so we're going to re-roll sixes. We'll do one of the other five, though. So sit back, relax, and enjoy some more Hammer Fantasy Battle Reports, yes?
Let's take a look at the vampire counts played by myself. This is 2,400 points of a lot of dogs. We'll get to the dogs in a moment, though. We're going to go off with my leadership. I got two lord level heroes here. I got a... Yeah, I'll start with my general. I got a vampire lord, ye old blender lord. You've seen him in the past. Probably. If you haven't, well, you're going to see a lot of him in the future. We've got him, level one wizard, lore of the vampires. We got invocation. Oh, well, not god invocation, but he will have invocation of the heck on him. He's going to have a shield, heavy armor, the night shroud, which is a vampire count specific armor upgrade, and other trickster shard, and the plus two strength sword. Now for his one... Other 100 points of upgrades. We have Red Fury, Quick Blood, and Beguile, which is the standard kind of Blender Lord build on him. I'm going with Beguile now because Dread Knight has screwed me over in like 3 games now off camera, so I am so done with that. My other Lord level hero here is a Master Necromancer that I quickly painted up showing off the contrast paints. I'm actually pretty pleased with how he came out in general. Every now and then they work really well, sometimes they just really don't, but this guy's got a lot of grooves to him, so kind of made for him in a way almost. Well, and a lot of other models. Anyway, level 4 Necromancer, Lore of Vampires. He is gonna have the Preservation Talisman, 4 open ward save. And he's gonna have a Dispel Scroll because you have to, as well as having the Ruby Ring of Ruin because I haven't used that in a while and I missed it. I'm trying out a normal vampire hero in this game. He's gonna be upgraded with the Vampiric Power Flying Horror, and I'm gonna give him, Fear Incarnate. Which makes them, if they ever have to, when it comes to fear checks, they have to reroll successful fear checks. If they have a BSB, it just counters each other out. He's gonna have heavy armor, dragon helmet, and the +2 attack sword, the Sword of Famine? Ah, whatever, +2 attack sword. It's gonna take me a bit to remember all the magic, the generic magic items. I just remembered, it's the Sword of Strife! And he's also a level 1 of death, actually. Yeah, I'm gonna go with death on him. Now for my core. Well, because we're playing at 2,400 points, I need 600 points of core. So that's going to be one squad of 30 skeletons, full command. We got some unit fillers there. We have one squad of 20 zombies, full command. I'm extending their base there because I plan on expanding upon them. Ooh, because of this one not fully fleshed out, that reminds me, my necromancer is a master of the dead. That means when he uses invocation of Nehek, he can increase zombies and skeletons past their maximum unit size. I usually take that upgrade, though it rarely does anything for me, but
whatever, I'm used to using it. I got another squad of 30 skeletons over here, a lot of unit filler for them, full command on them as well, and they're all swords and shields as well. And the zombies, if I didn't mention it, they have the banner and musician.
Four squads of dire wolves. I upgraded one of these to be a doom wolf. I'm gonna have the hardest time remembering which unit it is. I'm gonna go with the one with the green flock base. If I forget, well, I mean, it happens. The one in the middle there is going to be a Doom Wolf. That is the Doom Wolf. That means he has one extra attack. And I paid 10 points for that, folks, but I needed to flesh out my core. Now, this is my, well, this is my staple in pretty much any Vampire Count army I run. I won't be running this every game. This is what I'm used to running, so I'm trying to get back into the motion of the game, right? So 40 Graveguard with great weapons. We got full command. We got a champion there in the middle. Well, it's actually in the middle in this case. And we have a banner upgrade to the Banner of the Barrows, a standard upgrade for Graveguard. I mean, why wouldn't it be? And just it literally gives him plus one to hit, which is super powerful. One unit of Felbats, there's four of them here. I got yelled at when I tried to buy Battlescribe when I tried to add two units. Apparently you're only allowed to bring one unit of Felbats. Now I know.
No.
Now Steve is yelling at me in the background saying it's a Battlescribe glitch. In this case, don't care, I'm gonna go keep with the four Felbats anyways, because I don't know why, I was gonna go four Felbats. And lastly, we have one Terrorgeist. First time I brought this in a game when I was learning against Cullen, he shot it with a cannon right away. So I figured it was only fitting to bring it back again and have it be shot by a Warp Lightning Cannon this time. It was the Empire last time. And
cannons don't kill anything.
Yeah, it's true, Cullen's cannons. But he does have a personal engineer. How many of those do you have? One?
Only one.
As of right now, that's how you're recording this.
Now, if you choose to use it in the first game that we play together...
We'll see!
I mean, that's fine, I guess. I mean,
you can... I don't know, there's the strategy of, do I keep it for a clutch moment, or do I just burn it as fast as possible?
Because you won't remember it otherwise.
I don't know!
Well, I'm gonna roll for my level 4 Necromancer right now. You know what? I'll do my Vampire first. He's got Invocation. There we go. And I'll do the other little one. Oh, no, I'll actually do him later, because he's got Death. Here's my level 4. I got 1, 2, 3, and 4. Wow, nice. 1, 2, 3, 4. That's actually pretty ideal. That's like literally every spell I wanted. That's Von Hell's Hellish Vigor, Gaze, and Raise Dead. Oh. But I probably should give up one of those for Invocation, but I got the Ruby Ring of Ruin, so I'm probably gonna give up Gaze to have Invocation. So he's gonna have these four. I'm gonna roll for my Flying Horror Vampire. Here's Death. We got number 3, which is Soulblight. Oh, Soulblight's so good. Soulblight is so good. Oh man, oh, it's so good. It's many good, you know what? I think because I'm gonna build him as kind of like an assassin-y kind of guy, or to be obnoxious, I'm gonna go Spirit Leech, and it's easier to cast as well. He's level 1, Soul Blight's 9, so I'm gonna go Spirit Leech. And that is it for the Vampire Counts. On to the Skaven forces. Now we have the Skaven by Cullen at 2,400 points. What do you got?
All right, I guess you start with your character, so I'll start with mine. We're gonna start with the Warlord, our big old Gray Seer here. He's gonna be level 4 Wizard, of course. And he's going to have his typical Talisman of Preservation and the Earthing Rod.
Ooh.
And that's what he has. He starts the game with D3 Warpstone tokens, so we're gonna roll these cool Skaven dice that I hope show up on camera well.
Please do leave
feedback.
That's three, oh, nice. So he's gonna start with three of those. Now leave feedback down below what you think of these dice, because the only issue I see here is the fives and the fours are very similar from a distance, right?
So I wanna make sure if they're not good on camera, I'll switch back to normal dice so you guys can see them better, but we're gonna try it with this one, so I apologize if it's a little obscured. But then we're gonna go on to the Warlord over there, who is on his Rat Ogre Bonebreaker, and he's gonna have his Foul Pendant for a 5-up ward, Enchanted Shield, and the Sword of Anti-Heroes.
Does the Foul Pendant do anything else?
It's a 5-up ward.
That's it?
Yeah, it's just the additional 5-up ward.
So you can just take the other unnamed, or the Talisman of Protection or whatever?
Yes, the Protection, yeah.
Yeah.
And then we're going to have our BSB, who has a shield.
Sick build, bro.
Oh, yeah.
Does he have a magic banner at least?
No.
Okay, so he's literally no magics.
Oh, yeah. And we got our two
engineers.
Yeah. Like we normally do one of them, the guy with the green pipes over here. He will be a level 1 Wizard of Ruin. And his friend with the yellow pipes is the Doom Rocket.
Hello.
Caddy, jockey, whatever you want to call him. He wields it.
Is he going to have Warp Lightning then? Or are you going to roll for it then?
I'll roll for it to probably before the Gray Seer, just to see how these spells kind of work out, but most likely.
Core!
And moving on to my 907 points of core, which I don't see a problem with. We're going to start with our big unit of Storm Vermin. We got 50 strong.
Why are they core?
I don't know. They also have a Warp Fire Thrower with them, and they have the Razor Standard, giving their halberds armor piercing.
Oh, are they strength 3 base or 4 base?
They're strength 3.
So 4 with arm, so AP 2, or yeah, whatever. AP, yeah, arm pen 2, sure.
Yep. We got two units of 50 slaves, of course. We gotta bring the slaves. And they just got musicians. And our clan rat bunker, 30 strong, with a poison wind mortar, and of course, full command. And we've got our two rat darts for rat darting goodness and chaffing.
Apparently these are uncategorized. I've just found this out myself.
Yeah, they don't actually count as core, so they fit in this weird top of the list in Battlescribe. We've got our gutter runners, which I will hopefully remember.
Oh, you have to roll for them as reinforcements, oh, yeah. Don't you?
And actually, there's eight of them, so I need to pull one more out. Oh, but they have slings and poison attacks.
I'm just trying to remember. It's actually on a four up instead of a three up in this game, isn't it? Yeah, yeah, yeah. Oh boy, do I hate reinforcements in 7th edition 40k. Boy, is the 4-up not that much better! We have the eighth guy there now. Big guys!
Rare, two cannons, hellpit abomination, and a doom wheel.
And that's, I guess that's pretty much it, eh?
Oh yeah.
It's spell time, where are we starting?
Oh, we're gonna start with our level one. He could just get the spells that I don't want. One, he has Skitter Leap. See, that's one that I don't like rolling on my Greaseer. So it's, but I still think I'm going to give him Warp Lightning. It's okay. Just too...
It's reliable, mm-hmm. Right? All right, so what about your Greaseer?
Yeah. Actually. So I guess he can't learn Warp Lightning now, so...
Is that not like a signature spell for you?
It's a signature spell for only the Engineers.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, so two fives, a six, and a three. Interesting indeed.
So where would you like your five to go?
Well, Death Frenzy's nice. The question is do I want Crax Call? Because I could switch Scorch to Death Frenzy, then drop Crax Call for Curse.
That's true.
Okay, so looking at Luka's list one more time, I think I'm going to drop, let's go switch here, and then drop here.
Crax Call.
Because Crax Call is a line initiative, and
well, I have, actually, even the Graveguard are initiative 3, so that's a 50-50 you kill that.
I mean, the only thing is it's only 4.
46?
Oh, it's just a line, so it only hits the guys under the line.
Yeah, that's true.
So
you can try and target my characters, but they're all vampires with really high initiative.
Exactly. Yeah. So I think that's the best way to go.
Last thing we want to note is Dispel Scroll on the level 1 Engineer, which is the green tubes, right?
Yep.
Here is the table for today's game. Fantasy, so light on the train. It's been a very long time, right? Like, the recent fantasy games I've been playing have been just, like, bare tables. So
for sure.
Obviously, for the viewers, we wanted to put something down on the table. I hope you appreciate the irony with the statues.
It's something wonderful,
I think. It's something wonderful. Anyway, I like it. It looks pretty. It's not too much. It's manageable. And it looks like there's something here. It looks like it's telling a story, right? If you guys want more terrain, I know we do plan on doing really complex terrain-heavy battles in the future.
Sure.
Like, in cities, we're going to do, like, hill, like kind of like outside of city sieges, like right. Towers. There's going to be a lot going on in this upcoming, we'll call it a campaign, because it was a Kickstarter campaign. Speaking of Kickstarter campaigns, I would like to... I would like to throw a big thank you, right?
Lots of love.
Because without you supporters, everyone who supported, we're gonna put your names down. We really appreciate everything you've done for us. This wouldn't be happening.
Right, like, this is all because of you guys. So everyone out there who did not support the Kickstarter campaign, you have those people to thank because they are making us do this.
Right, this is happening because of them. Also, thank you to anyone who shared it. If you shared it and got the word out there, we really appreciated that too, because we were really, really excited to do this. We were a little nervous, and we're very pleased with the feedback you've been giving us so far. And obviously all the support. And now to the game. We're going to roll a D6, technically a D5. You're rolling sixes. I'll let Cullen do that.
Skaven Dice!
Two! I have no idea what the scenarios are anymore, because it's been so long. But I would also like to note, throughout this campaign, as I'll start calling it now, I would like to note we're going to invoke some special rules, house rules.
Yes.
Please give us some feedback on this, because if you...